This is health news that you need to hear. There's now an increased chance that you or loved one has what's considered high blood pressure. That's because health officials recently updated the guidelines. They lowered the threshold. Here to tell us how the guidelines work and what they mean for you, Dr. Tiffany Randolph. She's a cardiologist at Cone Health Medical Group Heart Care. Good morning.
Good morning.
They changed the numbers on us.
They did. So the American Heart Association and the American College of Cardiology recently lowered the guidelines. So in the past, blood pressure was always, high blood pressure was defined as greater than 140 over 90. Mm-hmm. With these new guidelines, it's now 130 over 80. So effectively, before, about 32% of adult Americans had hypertension, and now that's up to 46%.
So what was the reasoning behind that? That the higher numbers can lead to more problems, or is it a great reset for everybody to lower them down? What was the thinking that goes into that?
So a truly normal blood pressure is less than 120 over 80.
Okay.
And so we found that even small incremental increases in blood pressure are associated with increased risk of heart attacks and strokes. And so there was a reset to lower that down to a 130 over 80 so that we could protect more Americans from those events.
You need to know what the danger zone is, and all the chances are you're a little closer than you think you used to be. Mm-hmm. So this is something that we can change. There are some things we can't change. This is something we can. What are things that we can do in our lives to start making those numbers go a little lower?
That's a great question. There's a lot of things we can do. If everyone in this guideline actually has a higher emphasis on lifestyle changes, and by that I mean limiting the salt in your diet, increasing vegetables and fruit intake, exercising 90 to 150 minutes per week. Also, if you have sleep apnea, treating that, not smoking, all these things that we can do to lower our risk.
And now you just made something that you said to exercise. Everybody says, I don't have time. 90 to 120, 150 minutes in a week.
Right.
That can make a difference, and everybody can find that time.
Absolutely.
If you can find a time to put that in. Now, what you're not going to see this overnight, but if you make that committed effort, I gather you have seen people make real changes, right?
Absolutely. So for every 2 pounds that you lose, your blood pressure goes down by 1 point. Mm-hmm. So it really doesn't take that many pounds of weight loss to make a considerable difference in your blood pressure to where you may not even need medications.
Mm-hmm. And you mentioned some other things too. You know, lower blood pressure can help in a lot of other areas. It's not just, gee, my numbers are better. You're talking, make your heart better, you know, change your outcome in a lot of diseases too, right?
Absolutely. So high blood pressure is linked to heart attacks, strokes, kidney disease, sleep apnea. All of these things can get better by lowering your blood pressure.
Easy to do. Thank you so much for coming in and talking to us today.
Absolutely.
The numbers are lower. We need to pay attention and do something, right?
That's right.
Great advice. Thanks so much. Hey, if you want to learn more, Cone Health has just posted a new online video called Heart Health, Fact or Fiction. It's by Dr. Jake Hochrein. Look at it, conehealth.com/wellnessondemand. And remember, put the dashes in wellness on demand. You can watch that. You can learn more. Maybe things that you can share with other people too. There's also a cardiac family support group for heart and stroke patients and their loved ones too. You're invited. First quarterly meeting is this Tuesday from 6 to 8 p.m. Comes with dinner, and it's happening at Cone Hospital in Greensboro.